I want to thank my good friend from Oklahoma for the glowing recommendation there. I think I could have gotten a better one from Mr. Perlmutter over there. Hey, no. Thank you. It's great to be here. Great to be among friends, and great to see bipartisanship. This is an example of what the House of Representatives should do on a regular basis. Have fun. Joke around like Ranking Member Lucas and I do on a regular occasion. This is what we should do in a wide variety of other pieces of legislation, including what we want to do before the end of this month, how we want to fill the holes in the stimulus bill that we passed back months and months ago in a very bipartisan way. But I also have to raise some concerns about this piece of legislation, because the House Administration Committee got this bill sent to the committee last November, and unfortunately has been the norm in this Congress, and especially on this committee, we didn't hold one meaningful hearing or markup on this bill. The chair waived jurisdiction in February, and now 7 months later, this bill is on the House floor without ever being discussed by the committee with its jurisdiction over federal election issues. H.R. 4990 allocates over $100 million across the next 5 years to the National Institute of Standards and Technology in order to conduct an election system research and distribute grants to higher ed institutions and nonprofits. Funding expanded research at NIST, a non-regulatory agency of the Department of Commerce, would allow the agency to circumvent policy priorities set by the U.S. Elections Assistance Commission, a politically balanced agency. This is especially concerning when we know there have already been calls for more transparency when it comes to the work that NIST does on behalf of the EAC. Currently, EAC commissioners are not regularly updated on the projects that they task NIST with. There is no timeline for completion and no reporting structure. H.R. 4990 further empowers NIST without proportional accountability to the EAC. I've addressed this issue previously in my bill, H.R. 5707, the Protect American Voters Act, PAVA, by calling election-related work of NIST to be more accessible and visible by directing them to issue a report to Congress every year containing the status, timeline, and estimated completion of activities that they're tasked with under HAVA. Additionally, H.R. 4990 would expand the voting system definition to include non-voting technology in the already overwhelmed voluntary voting systems guidelines process. We've been waiting for updated HAVA guidelines, or VVSG 2.0, for over a decade now. So while I absolutely believe guidelines for non-voting equipment such as e-poll books are needed, adding more to the VVSG process likely isn't going to get this done. My bill PAVA addresses this by bypassing the costly and time-consuming VVSG process and calls for the EAC to establish a separate process for testing and certifying guidelines for non-voting election equipment. The bottom line, H.R. 4990 does not update HAVA and allocates over $100 million to the discretion of NIST rather than investing in the bipartisan independent government agency created by Congress. And that agency is well-versed in elections. EAC provides guidance, not mandates. Keeping the power at the EAC preserves states' primary and constitutional role in administering federal elections. This House should work in a real, bipartisan fashion to create the election reform that the American people deserve. I'm willing and ready whenever my colleagues on both sides of the aisle would like to do this. I do believe, and I'm happy we see bipartisanship today, as this bill works its way through the process after it passes today. I certainly hope that the sponsors and my colleagues can work with us to address some of the concerns that I raised today. And with that, I'll thank again Ranking Member Lucas. I'll give him a glowing recommendation, too, of nothing. And I want to thank the sponsors of this bill, Ms. Cheryl, Mr. Gonzalez, for your work in this field. I would like to work with you to address some of these concerns as we move it to the Senate. Thank you for your time today, and I yield back.